sweat test. If you're anything like me, you've probably had your share of bonks in long races, marathons, ultras. Fueling and hydration could be one of the most frustrating things to dial in. I know from personal experience. Most people have no clue what their baseline sweat rate is. So I've been testing this product recently. It's called an hDrop hydration sensor. This is not a sponsored video. This is not a promotional video. This sensor was provided to me at no cost for test and review for roadtrailrun.com by hDrop. So I've been doing a few test runs, both outdoors, indoors here on my treadmill, and I've kind of come across some eye-opening results. And I figured it would probably be useful if I shared those results and maybe gone through the process of running different scenarios. As a first step, the best thing to do is establish your baseline sweat rate. So for this initial test run, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna use this hDrop test monitor on my run, but I'm also gonna go through the manual process. Now that process involves weighing myself before and after my run, and also weighing whatever I'm gonna consume during my run. From there, you're obviously gonna get a difference in weight, and that is gonna be your sweat rate. So that number, I'm gonna compare to the value that hDrop reads from its sensor here. So first things first, let's go and prep my nutrition and hydration for this run, weigh myself, and then I'll hop on the treadmill and get running. All right, so what we're doing now is we have to weigh everything that we're gonna consume during our test run. I filled this bottle up, 16 ounces. I'm going with liquid IV here. It's got 530 milligrams of sodium in here. Whatever you're gonna consume, if that's a gel or anything else during your run, you need to weigh it before and after. 558 grams. Striker gel here, not crazy about this one, but when we're done with this test run, whatever's left in this bottle, even if it's empty, I'm gonna weigh this bottle when I'm done, and I'm also gonna weigh the wrapper, because you may not necessarily take in all of this, and also the wrapper itself has a small amount of weight. Some of them, you know, with a screw cap or whatever, may have a little bit more weight to them. So if you're doing this kind of sweat test for a longer run, and if you're not at home, make sure that you're bringing your wrappers home, because that's going to be a little bit of weight, and you don't want to have the weight of the wrappers factor into your calculations and throw your numbers all off. Oops, just gel here. Got my bottle and my gel weighed. Now it's time to weigh myself. Okay, so you want to get an accurate reading here. It doesn't need to be 1000% accurate in an absolute sense, but you do want to make sure you get a good relative difference between your weight before the run and your weight after the run. Of course, we are getting naked. Okay, so I weighed myself, weighed all my fluid and my gel. I got that up on the treadmill up there. So I'm gonna do, since it's an easy run, I don't need to go crazy on my warm up. I'm gonna do about 10 minutes warm up, and then I'll do a solid 60 minutes steady. I don't have a plan for what I'm gonna set the treadmill at. Just see how I feel. It doesn't really matter. Got my tripod. Missing a little holster. I'll be back. Okay, got it. Use my stride pods on the treadmill because the distance accuracy is impeccable. And also I could factor in the incline for my wattage. Coros armband for heart rate. Got the hDrop sensor. This goes on my left arm. As you can see, it's a little bit thicker than the Coros band, but not that much. Very light. Don't notice it at all. Just gonna put it on here so it has good contact. It doesn't need to be super tight. It just needs to be stable. So that feels good. So I have to get the hDrop app going here. Since I'm indoors, I'm gonna use the phone here to record the activity. Oh, got this on the treadmill. Here we go. I'm gonna take some screenshots
of the sensor screen here as I go. So in future videos, there's a lot of features in this. There's a sweat zones calculator, which is the main display on the phone as I'm running now. It's a gauge that shows you whether your sweat is either concentrated, i.e. a lot of sodium, or diluted, i.e. possibly too much water. It also shows sodium loss, fluid loss, and temperature sensor. All right, so I hit the 30-minute mark. I've got 9.5 ounces of fluid loss, according to the app. That's close to 20 ounces per hour. One thing to notice when you're taking your fuel and hydration, make sure you don't spill anything. Don't spill half the gel on the floor, and don't squirt half the fluid down your chin or everywhere. Because when you weigh yourself at the end, that's gonna get accounted for as fluids lost when it's really on the ground somewhere. So at 50 minutes, I took my first drink. Normally, I would definitely drink earlier. I'd start drinking 20 or so, 30 minutes in. But I wanted the, for the purposes of this test, the hDrop app stabilize a bit. So we've got roughly 15 minutes to go. Then I'll probably cool down 5 or 10 minutes. See how I feel. Probably 10, just to kind of let all the sweat come out as I cool down. Get a better reading. Alright, 5 minutes to go in my 60-minute block. It's reading 25 ounces of fluid loss right now, over a total of an hour and 5 minutes. 1368 sodium loss, and my sweat zones number is showing about 54 in the green zone. As I'm rounding out this 60 minutes here, kind of settled back in to the mid upper 140s. So 150 is about 75% max heart rate for me. So I'm in my aerobic zone, zone 2, easy run zone, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to cool down for 10 minutes, gradually dial down the speed, finish my drink here. Okay, empty. Gonna weigh this. Got my gel wrapper in here. Gonna weigh that when I'm done. Will mention, I do have the slight urge to pee. But when you're doing the sweat test, try not to go to the bathroom in any sense. Because, again, that's a different kind of fluid loss, and you don't want to factor that in as sweat. Got 8.82 miles on my treadmill, 8.77 tripods. Finish activity, are you sure you are done? Yes. Processing my data. Excellent. We can start undressing. Kane footwear. This is just for my sweaty feet on the way to the bathroom. Take it now. Make sure you have a towel handy. You want to towel yourself off. 135.8. Triple check. 135.8. So I just got off the scale, 135.8. So
So by rough math, that's 1.4 pounds of fluid loss. Generally, I find that this doesn't weigh too much. So I may have to weigh that with the bottle. See, I get zero now, but it's probably nothing worth accounting for. I drank all of this, so we're gonna go 78 on that. And then I feel like this helps with the reading if I put them together. 80, so 82. Okay, so we'll go 4 grams for the wrapper. Okay, so I got my numbers in front of me. I got my activity analysis, 135.8, 1.4. I can do math. The bottle, what was that? 78, and I had 4 grams on the wrapper. So that gives me 41.8 ounces manually measured. And if I check my hDrop, 45.9. That is a difference of 8.9%. Yes, you should be sweat testing yourself. I've got my results here from the run that I just typed in. I came up with 41.8 ounces of fluid loss. That's manually measured, not from this hDrop device. This hDrop device gave me 45.9 ounces. So the difference there is 8.93% between the device and what I manually measured. That was an hour, 20 minute run on the treadmill, easy pace. If I'm going through the hDrop device, which I'm gonna use going forward for my testing, I'm not gonna go through this whole manual process for more advanced scenarios. It gives me a sweat rate of 34.4 ounces per hour. And that includes a 10 minute warm up where I was jogging pretty slow and then a 10 minute pretty slow cool down. Just think about that for a second. I took in 16 ounces of fluid on that run and I lost 45.9 ounces. You may have a lower sweat rate than me, but you may also have high numbers like this. You may have a higher sweat rate than you think you have. If you go out and run, train for an hour, train for 2 hours, that kind of difference between what you're actually losing in your sweat and what you're replacing with hydration, that's not gonna make a whole lot of a difference. As I was talking about on the run, I was pretty much fully hydrated before I started that run. I only took in 16 ounces, so I really didn't feel too much during that run. What if you get in the latter stages of a marathon? You're 3 hours in, 4 hours in, an ultra race where you're 10 hours in for a 1 hour run, won't even notice it. 2 hours, 3 hours, okay, maybe you feel a little tired after the run. Oh, maybe you think, oh, it's my training, I need to train more. Maybe you're not hydrating enough. Maybe I'm not hydrating enough. When I say you, I mean me, okay? We're in this together. 20 plus ounce difference after 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 10 hours, 20 hours. Why are you really bonking in some of these races? Why am I bonking in some of these races? This is pretty eye-opening for me. In the testing that I've done with this app, I've been really impressed with the accuracy. The manual sweat testing I've done 3 times. This time I got a 9% difference. On a previous run, I got a 7% difference. Another previous run, I got a 5% difference. In the range of 5 to 9% for something where you don't have to worry about weighing everything that you're consuming and getting naked and weighing yourself before and after and all this, it's something that you could take with you and literally measure yourself on every run. I didn't have any intention of doing sweat testing or hydration analysis as part of this channel, but this has really inspired me and given me a lot of ideas for different types of ways that I could test this. Pre-fueling, under-fueling, bicarb, taking in tons of fluid while I'm on the run, different conditions, indoors, outdoors. I mean, with the treadmill, I could really dial in. I could also cross-reference that with what I'm doing outside on long runs, short runs, harder runs, steadier runs, interval runs. It's pretty much endless. And the fact that I don't have to worry about disposable patches, I think it has the potential to be a game changer. So If you have any questions about sweat testing in general, or you have questions specifically about this device, let me know down in the comments. I could even do a Q&A if I get enough feedback. I have a lot of stuff in my head that I want to try out. So going forward, I will be posting, I don't know what I would call it yet, maybe sweat series of different types of testing. It's January, what is it? It's January 3rd now. So racing season is far enough away that I feel like I could really utilize this to dial in my hydration going into the season. I have several months to really work on this. Really, if you want to join me and come along on this journey, I think you could really learn a lot. I think everybody can learn a lot. Some of these numbers are downright shocking to me that I'm seeing on here. And the fact that I cross-reference this, as you saw, by manually measuring it and testing the accuracy of this, it's kind of blowing my mind by how much I have not been hydrating myself enough probably in the past. Please stay tuned, like and subscribe. Like I said, if you have any questions about this device or sweat testing, hydration strategies, if you have tips for me, your own experiences with your own sweat testing and how you possibly change your fueling and hydration strategies, I'd love to hear about it. So leave everything in the comments. I'll see you again for more sweat testing and hydration testing.